Hello, and thank you for purchasing the Tracker version of the Houston Radar Armadillo. This version can be used to count vehicles, record speeds, and estimate size. In this short film, we will cover how to properly install the unit on the road. Here, we have the Armadillo attached to a mounting bracket. If you look at the top of the unit, you will see that there is a slider plate for angle adjustment. On the bottom, you will see a key switch and a single connector for both USB connections and the high-speed AC charger. On this particular unit, there is a second solar panel connector. This connector will only be present on Armadillos with the solar option. Because of the Armadillo's ultra-low power consumption and MPPT solar charger technology, it is capable of running almost indefinitely when paired with a 5 or 10 watt solar panel. The MPPT charger will allow the Armadillo to maximize the available solar power and perform quite well even under an overcast sky. This is ideal for more permanent installations. If you have purchased the solar option, you will also need this two-wire cable to connect your solar panel to the Armadillo. Included with all Armadillo purchases are two quick-release metal straps for attaching the Armadillo to a pole and two keys used to switch the Armadillo on and off. To mount the Armadillo, you will need a wrench, slotted screwdriver, or 3/8 inch hex socket and driver. To install and adjust the solar panel, you will need a wrench or a socket driver with the following hex sockets: 5/16, 7/16, and 1/2 inch. If you are installing a solar panel, you will most likely need a ladder. The Armadillo can monitor traffic for any two lanes adjacent to the unit, so long as there are no more than two lanes per direction. The Armadillo can be mounted in the following scenarios: on the side of a two-lane undivided road in which traffic flows in both directions, on the side of a two-lane undivided road in which traffic flows in a single direction, in the median of a two- or four-lane road in which traffic is flowing in both directions. The unit can be used to reliably record traffic for the inner two lanes of a four-lane road, so long as traffic in the outermost two lanes flow in the opposite direction. Data will still be recorded for the outer lanes, but should be discarded. The Armadillo should not be mounted on a road with more than two lanes of traffic in a single direction. The Armadillo can only count free-flowing vehicles and should not be installed in locations where traffic is expected to come to a halt. Avoid mounting the Armadillo near stoplights or stop signs, wherever possible. If this is unavoidable, please install the unit in a location at least 100 feet away in both directions and always point the unit in the direction opposite the light or sign. Vehicles entering or exiting the road in front of the unit should be counted properly, so long as they are not doing so within the 100-foot section of road immediately in front of the unit. The Armadillo must have an uninterrupted view of the road. Do not install behind objects such as tree branches or bushes. The radar should be mounted within 12 feet of the nearest lane. The unit should be installed 6 to 12 feet above the road. This allows the unit to see over most vehicles in the near lane. Use the slider plate to adjust the downward angle of the unit so that it is pointed about 75 to 100 feet up the road. The front of the unit is the large blank surface directly opposite the mounting bracket. The slider plate should be pulled out approximately halfway when the unit is 6 feet above the road and all the way when the unit is 12 feet above the road. Turn the unit so that it points toward the middle of the road approximately 75 to 100 feet away. The unit should be parallel to the road when installed on a road median. One of the greatest advantages of the Armadillo is its adaptability. Extreme precision during installation is not required. Follow these guidelines using your best judgment, and don't worry too much about the exact angle to the road, offset from the road, or mounting height. Insert the quick-release metal straps through the slots on the side of the Armadillo mounting bracket. Loop the straps around the pole and position the Armadillo. Tighten the straps using the wrench, slotted screwdriver, or 3/8 hex socket. Verify that the excess straps are not blocking the front of the unit. Using the included key, switch the Armadillo on. One long beep indicates a charge level of greater than 30%, while multiple short beeps indicate a charge level below 30%. Once powered up, the Armadillo should produce a short beep for every vehicle logged within the first 5 minutes. Use this to verify proper detection in this new installation. Due to the tracking nature of this radar, vehicles can be logged at various points in the road. Incoming vehicles are typically logged as they pass by the radar, while outgoing vehicles are typically logged between 75 to 300 feet away from the radar. These results, however, can vary from vehicle to vehicle. When using a GPS-equipped Armadillo, it is important to power the unit off and then back on again in each new location. This signals the armadillo to acquire new coordinates. Verify that the weatherproof connector caps are secured.
If you are installing a solar panel, it is important to note that the orientation of the panel can significantly affect performance. Point the panel towards true south, not magnetic south, if you are in the northern hemisphere, or true north if you are in the southern hemisphere. You can use the compass on most smartphones to find true north or south. The optimal tilt angle is your latitude plus 15 degrees from horizontal.
It is important that the solar panel has a direct view of the sky. Try to avoid mounting the solar panel under any sort of coverage, such as trees. If a single cell on the panel is covered, the output for the entire panel will be significantly reduced.
To prepare the solar panel for mounting, place the solar panel arm assembly on the bracket.
To install the solar panel bracket, slide the metal straps through the mounting bracket. Wrap the cables around the pole above the armadillo and begin tightening. Do not fully tighten the cables until you have finished positioning the bracket so that it is facing the correct direction.
Plug the solar panel cable into the armadillo and tighten the connector.
If you want to check the performance of your solar installation, you may do so by using Houston Radar Stats Analyzer software.